A Melbourne-led team has for the first time shown that 800,000 brain cells living in a dish can perform goal-directed tasks, in this case, the simple tennis-like computer game Pong. The results of the study are published in the journal Neuron. Now they are going to find out what happens when their dish brain is affected by medicines and alcohol. The researcher says that DishBrain offers a similar approach to test how the brain works and gain insights into debilitating conditions such as epilepsy and dementia. While scientists have for some time been able to mount neurons on multi-electrode arrays and read their activity, this is the first time that cells have been stimulated in a structured and meaningful way. By building a living model brain from basic structures in this way, scientists will be able to experiment using real brain function rather than flawed analogous models like a computer. The research team will next experiment to see what effect alcohol has when introduced to this brain. The researcher says that they are trying to create a dose response curve with ethanol, basically get them drunk and see if they play the game more poorly, just as when people drink. That potentially opens the door for completely new ways of understanding what is happening with the brain. The findings also raise the possibility of creating an alternative to animal testing when investigating how new drugs or gene therapies respond in these dynamic environments. To perform the experiment, the research team took mouse cells from embryonic brains as well as some human brain cells derived from stem cells and grew them on top of microelectrode arrays that could both stimulate them and read their activity. Electrodes on the left or right of one array were fired to tell this brain which side the ball was on, while distance from the paddle was indicated by the frequency of signals. Feedback from the electrodes taught this brain how to return the ball by making the cells act as if they themselves were the paddle.